Hi, welcome to my video. My name is Dr. Deji. I'm a huge One Piece fan, and I just finished seeing the movie One Piece Red, and I will now say it's the best movie I've ever seen in my life. I was a big fan of One Piece, and I really like, the show and all that. I'm not up to date right now, but this video will have some spoilers, but I just wanted to highlight some of the best scenes from One Piece Red, in my opinion. I loved One Piece Red. It is now my favorite movie of all time. Before, it was Back to the Future Part 2 for personal reasons, but One Piece Red has now taken that spot. I'm currently not up to date. It is June 2023. We're in the Wano arc, and the last thing I remember was Luffy is fighting Kaido, and yeah. So there's gonna be spoilers in this, so you have been warned. If you have not seen the One Piece Red, should you see it? Yes, you should see it. It's a good movie. It's really good. It's really good. The first, it's about 2 hours long, and then the first hour and a half was eh, but the last 30 minutes, man, it was crazy. So most of these photos are from the last 30 minutes. So if you haven't seen the movie, please go see it. Don't watch this video. But if you've seen the movie, then you can watch, go through this with me and just, my emotions were going crazy. If I was in a movie theater, I would be freaking out. But I'm at home. If you don't know how to watch the movie, feel free to message me. Yeah, I can give you some tips. Okay. So, One Piece Red is a great movie. It's a movie about Uta, which I think means singing. I'm not sure, but Uta is a girl who's, Shanks's daughter. They alluded to it in the show. But we never ever heard of it until they alluded it in the show. I don't know how you guys felt, but when I heard that Shanks had a daughter, I was freaking out. I'm like, well, we can't just add that, for a movie. That's a big deal. What do you mean Shanks has a daughter? What do you mean? But the movie did a really good job in tying it in. And is it canon? You can make it canon if you really want to. The movie was that good, so I highly recommend watching it. Okay, so there's a couple scenes I wanted to share that I loved, and again, it's a spoiler alert, but I'm going in. This first scene, and you can see my mouse, Luffy is talking with Uta. This is her side profile. And Uta asks the question, why do you want to be the Pirate King? For a One Piece fan, I knew that Luffy said that he wanted to be the Pirate King to have the most freedom. Because there's a person that has the most freedom, and then that's the same thing that Gold Roger said, and he said it multiple times. The most notable time, I believe, is in the Sabaody Archipelago, when he was with Dark King Rayleigh, and he liked the adventure, even though he could have got some answers, but he decided not to. So I knew that he wanted to, and I had a kind of a reason, but I never knew exactly why. So Uta is asking him, why is he a pirate anyways? Why does he want to be the Pirate King? And he says to make a new era. And, to me, that's wow. Luffy is everybody knows he's stupid, but he's also extremely smart. Not just battle IQ, but personally. He has an understanding of the world that is, really crazy. Hence, some of the things in the beginning, early on, whether it was All Along and understanding the room, the pain that was in Nami's room, or fast forward to Alabastar and, allowing Vivi to beat him up and then he punched her back or something, to let her know that, this is what life is. Luffy just has those times of understanding people. When Nami was stabbing herself and telling Luffy to go away, and Luffy didn't go away, he just stayed and it was silent. And then waited for Nami to ask for help. Just his understanding of, yeah. So to make a new era, is that really his answer? Of course, it's an English translation, so I don't know what the actual Japanese words were, but crazy, crazy answers to me. We have a reason for Luffy why he's pursuing his dream to be the Pirate King, to start a new era. The next picture I wanted to share was this picture. So this was a flashback picture. This is, again, this is a spoiler alert for the movie, but there's a big monster in the movie called the Demon King, which is an embodiment, I guess it's like a demon of the Thutmose, which is this ancient weapon. So it is a lot of stuff there, you know. Like, we know that the devil fruits are, like, some people would say, I think Shanks himself said it's like the reincarnation of the devil. Or, like, devil fruits have a mind of its own. We don't know how Uta Uta got the devil fruit, but we do know that the Thutmose is a demon that was able to tempt Uta to, like, you know, release him, basically. So this is the scene where Shanks is attacking the Demon King. And this is Shanks with not just one hand, but two hands. So his one hand, this is a sword, and then the other hand is here. And for me, this is the first realization that I realized, oh, wait, Shanks has two arms in all the flashback scenes, which means that we could get a really good detail of his power level. I didn't take a picture of it, but in the movie, his bounty, after he fought the Thutmose, the Demon King, which he fought years ago, like maybe 10, 15 years ago, with just his crew. You know, they fought it again in the movie, but they fought it with, like, a bunch of people. But just his crew alone was enough to stop it. Yeah, it was 1 billion belly. So, with two hands, you know, back when Luffy was just a kid, like 5 years old, his bounty was 1 billion belly. So, when that mountain bandit who had, like, a 30 million bounty was, like, bullying Shanks, Shanks' bounty was 1 billion. And for those who know, Luffy's, I don't know what his newest bounty is, but right now his bounty is 1.5 billion in the beginning of the Wano arc. So, like, it just shows you how strong Shanks was. Like, Luffy was pretty crazy already, you know? So, for a mountain bandit, you know, Shanks is humble. Anyways, really cool. We get somewhat of his power level and his strength before he lost his arm. The next picture I wanted to share was this one. This is Usopp. They're fighting the Thutmose, and here he uses observation haki to be able to connect with his dad. So, and this is the realization that his dad is here. So then they go on an amazing father-son combo, you know, organizing all the attacks, and then he does a final attack. And it was just beautiful, bro. It was beautiful. And the biggest thing for me is that Usopp hasn't seen his dad for a long time. I think he was old enough to know his dad, and I don't remember. I remember Usopp was saying that his dad is an amazing pirate. We don't know anything about his mom, but we know the dad, you know, was meant for the seas. So here is, like, Usopp's first time seeing his dad in who knows how long, maybe like 10, 15 years or something. So I thought it was a really great photo, and it just got me yelling, jumping out of my seat. And happy Valentine's Day. The next photo, speaking of dads, as you guys know, Shanks is Uta's father. But this is a flashback scene of where Shanks, Uta, and, you know, let me just give some respect to Ben Beckman here. I love this photo because for many reasons. Number one, this is Shanks without the scar. So this is young Shanks. But he's still the leader of the Redhead Pirates. He wasn't just a lackey on the Gold Roger ship. And he's opening up a chest, and there's a baby Uta in it. And he proceeds to try to sing to the baby, which, and then Uta was able to calm down. So for Uta, Shanks was like the first person. And we know that that time of One Piece, there's like it's not unusual to find kids who don't have any parents. Nami and her sister were like that too. And then they were adopted by a Navy Marine. Shanks basically is gonna adopt Uta. And then we have a flashback. Shanks, like, he sees Uta, and then he thinks of Gold Roger and Silver's Rayleigh, and then the dual sword guy, and basically is saying that Shanks too was found by Gold Roger. So Gold Roger raised the baby on his ship, and the baby was Shanks. So in a sense, Gold Roger's son, his real son is Ace, but his adopted son is Shanks, in a sense. Him and Silver Spear Lee's adopted son. So, and Silver Spear Lee, as we know, is a master of hockey. So Shanks must be a master of hockey. And they're both swordsmen, and Shanks is a master swordsman. So you can see, like, that's really, really cool how they cameoed this in it. And it's just so funny looking at this shocked face. Another thing about this scene is that it's not Gold Roger's first time having a baby. I think they, in the scene where he adopted, not adopted, but Odin from the Wano arc, when they were working together, Odin and his wife, I forgot her name, Taiyuya? I forgot her name. But they had Momonosuke and the daughter and his sister on the ship. And Gold Roger says, "Oh my gosh, it's been a long time since we had a baby." So I think that's in reference to Shanks. Next scene. Oh, you gotta pay this scene respect. This scene was so sick, bro. Like I was just like out of my seats for this one. I'm gonna shrink my photo here. This is an attack, and it's just a cool scene, but it's a lot. You have Shanks doing a right hand punch, and it becomes a falcon, which I don't know if there's a meaning behind it. And then we have Luffy doing a right hand punch, and it's a lion. And it's just a sick picture. They're fighting the top Muzika, and they got to do simultaneous attacks on. And it's just like the fact that Luffy's bigger is like showing that he's taking over and bringing it in the new era. But the other big thing about this attack, as you might can tell, this is a different form. His hair is different here, and you'll see it in the next photo. And it's very short when they did it. He was in Snake Man when he was attacking, but now this is obviously not Snake Man. Snake Man has hockey on his arms, and he doesn't have hockey on his arms, and he usually is like more muscular. So this is like a different form, hence the term Gear 5, which we have not seen in the anime yet. Oh, maybe it has. I'm behind, so. This is the afterwards effect. We have Shanks on the right side and Luffy on the... Shanks on the right side, Luffy on the left side, which is, you know, Shanks is on the right side here. Left side. You get it. I have it. I have both the photos. That's kind of cool. But Luffy's white. Zoom in. He's white. So, that's the new form. Which is possibly to say that this form is as strong as Shanks. Maybe. I don't know. But that's pretty crazy. And it kind of shows how strong the demon is. You know? But yeah, I thought it was cool. We get a little glimpse of Gear 5. Whatever it is. I'm not there yet. I was already like done with this movie. Like all this was crazy to me. Flashbacks in the middle. Like all these crazy scenes. And then afterwards they defeat the demon, but everybody's not back yet. And, they think that the Marines in the real world think that they need to kill Uta to release everybody. Shanks was not having it. He was pretty pissed off. And this is probably the most serious we've ever seen him. He says that Uta is my daughter. And if you guys want to take her, you got to get through me. And he proceeds to do an Emperor's hockey. Which knocks out even some of the vice admirals. Of course, Kizaru and the other dude who does the gravity thing. I'm forgetting anybody's name. It's like late over here. They could withstand the hockey, but he knocks out everybody. Puts one of the vice admirals to his knees. And it was just a sick scene. I'm like, dang, you get to face the hockey of Shanks. So I think that's really crazy. All right, next scene. All right, so the movie ended. We have credit scene, and there's a lot of awesome photos in the credit scene, but I just love this one. If you know, then you know this is Rika's onigiri. So Rika is one of the girls. It's the girl that, like, tried to feed Zoro when he was arrested early on. And he feeds him with the onigiri. The rich guy takes the onigiri, throws it on the floor, and smashes it, and then Zoro eats it off the floor. But Zoro's one of his favorite attacks is onigiri, and I think it was inspired by Rika. So she's doing well for herself. So, you know, she's a little bit older. She's still rocking the same hoodie and the same pigtails, But she got her own job, so I thought that was adorable. And then the last scene, I just, you know, this is Bon Clay. And I believe this is New Kama Land, you know. But I thought Bon Clay was dead. I didn't know he was alive. I think some people say that they knew he was alive because he was beaten by Magellan and impaled down. But, like, you know, Magellan doesn't kill people. He imprisons them. So he probably imprisoned Mr. Two, Bon Clay, and then he later escaped. So he's doing very well for himself. Everybody's just having fun. And I believe this is New Kama Land. I think the chains kind of show it. If you go back and look at Imperial Ivankov at New Kama Land, they have the same chains, I believe. But yeah, so that's pretty much it. I'm gonna put this photo here. My favorite photo out of these probably has to be this one. It's just so cool. I might make this one my background. But essentially, the movie was really good. I highly recommend it. There was a lot of teasers of different topics there, whether we talk about the power of, like, the fact that Uta fruit was called Uta. Her name is Uta, but the fruit is called Uta Uta fruit. Uta Uta no Mi. You know, the Sing Sing fruit. We could talk about how devil fruits find people. Of course, it's the plot, but, you know, it's kind of amazing. We could talk about Shanks's power level and how he was 1 billion. This is a kind of a spoiler, and I didn't know about this till now, but I live in Japan, and they released One Piece Red mangas everywhere. But the manga is called Volume 4 Million, and I think Volume 2 Million, and we didn't know why it was called 4 million, but it's called 4 million because that's Shanks' bounty right now. So if I just do a quick Google search, the strongest man right now is probably Kaido. So his bounty is, there you go, 4 billion. So yeah, okay, so Kaido is still higher, 4.6 billion. Anyways, I didn't know his bounty. So yeah, whatever. That's not that big of a deal. What other stuff do I want to say before I end this video? Watch the movie. What else do I want to say? One thing I do want to mention is that he doesn't have a scar here. But I think, he doesn't have a scar here, but like when he is with, grown up, when he's like in this fight, when he's with grown a little bit older, maybe like 5-6 years old. No, I think she was 10 years old, like 10-11 years old. Between this time and about 10-11 years, when Uta was older and she was able to sing, he has a scar. So the scar that he got on his left eyes and that scar from Blackbeard was from like early time, and I think we know that. They showed it in one of the flashbacks during the time of Odin, because we see Blackbeard on the crew with Gold Roger. I believe it was back then. So, and then he, you know, of course he left, and then he joined Whitebeard's crew. So he was scheming for a minute. Some people say that the Taut Musica demon resembles Blackbeard. So, like a foreshadowing of that final battle between, it'll probably be Shanks and Luffy versus Blackbeard. What else? We noticed that we saw, I don't have a picture of it, but we have the whole crew for Shanks, and there's 10 people, and Luffy has a crew of 10 people. So it's like, we know there's not going to be any more added. And yeah. I think I'm going to stop there. The movie was great. It is now my favorite movie of all time. And I love One Piece. And I'm so happy. Y'all have a blessed day. And God, remember, God loves you.